These Final Cut Pro 10.8 features will change your workflow. I'm going to share with you my favorite features from the last update, the 10.8 update, but not all the features, just what I like. I'm going to make it very practical today. Let's put a clip on the timeline and we're going to slow it down. Click here and you will see this new smooth slow-mo option. This wasn't there before. This is new. And so I'm going to choose just 50%. Let's look at this. Okay, down here on the left, check this out, analyzing for machine learning optical flow. AI these days is all about machine learning, where the AI analyzes the available data and then it makes the best prediction it can to provide new data that wasn't there. In this case right here, it analyzes the available data in this clip and then it blends video frames to produce high quality slow motion footage. It's supposed to create something really smooth because it's called smooth, right? It's in the name. Let's see. Check out the smoothness in these clips. It's not bad. It's not bad. You can also access this feature by pressing Command R. That will activate the retime option. And then click here. You will see the smooth slow-mo right there. If you want more control, you can click on Custom. And then you can choose the percentage you like. And down here, you can choose the method you want Final Cut Pro to use to slow down this clip. Just a quick note, guys, you will get the best result on shots that were shot on a high frame rate, like 60 frames per second or 120 frames per second. I tested it. I mean, push this machine learning smooth slow-mo feature on this very complex clip right here. It was shot at a low frame rate, and this is the result. Yeah, it has its limitations, but it's a very good quality feature, and I personally like it. Again, don't forget to put in the comment section what feature you actually like from the last update. Let's go back to the clip. This is the log footage, which brings me to my second favorite feature from the last update. First, let's bring back the contrast. It's just one clip, so I'm going to duplicate it by pressing Option and drag it up. Then I change the blend mode to overlay or soft light. I'm gonna go overlay today. Then with the bottom clip, I'll click the magic wand and choose enhance light and color. And look at that, it automatically color corrected the footage. Look at the video inspector on the right. There's a new adjustment color there. Let's check it out. So these are the tonal contrast or brightness adjustment that the AI did. And down here are the color contrast adjustments. What I like with this is that I still have some control right here. I can still move these sliders if I'm not satisfied with what the AI did. And I like that. I like that a lot. I'm cool with the AI technology, but I still want some level of control so that I can tweak it to my preference, you know, because I'm the artist. The AI is just a tool. I'm also gonna add a color wheels adjustment and I'm gonna try to get a quick look. We're not gonna do something fancy here. I'm gonna link a color grading tutorial up here. But this is just gonna be basic. Let's add some warmth by moving this slider to the right. I also wanna add some magenta in there while keeping my eyes on my scopes and my histogram on the left. Let's also add a little bit of magenta or blue in the shadow, some orange or yellow in the highlights, and the same in the midtones. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna add more contrast with a curve adjustment. I'm gonna lower the dark tones and bring the mid-tone and the brighter tones back on the line. There you go. I said just a quick warm look right here. I like it. Just a quick, really quick, basic warm look. And this next feature is what we've been waiting for, what Final Cut Pro users have been waiting for a long time. If I click here, I can rename this correction. A simple feature, but I mean, we've been waiting for this. It helps a lot when it comes to organization. I actually prefer going back to the video inspector tab so that I can see all the corrections we did. And I'm gonna click here. There is the rename option. Let's call this color correction. This one, maybe warm tone. And this one, just contrast. I mean, keeping it simple today, keeping it simple. Again, guys, I'm just showing the possibilities you have here. I'm simplifying it today. But there is one last thing, and this is probably my favorite out of all the features I talked about in this video today. Let's take this second clip and put it next to this one. I'm gonna do the same thing we did with the other clip, duplicate it and all the other steps we did earlier. But when it comes to the color adjustment part, with this new update, I'm just gonna click on this first one and press and hold shift. Click on the last adjustments and then drag all of them to this clip. And boom! Now that's gonna change my workflow. I mean, that is pretty cool. Of course, these clips were taken in the same location, probably around the same time of the day, so it's easy to match. But still, this feature is crazy. I mean, I love it. It's just crazy good. I used to use the shortcuts Command-C and then Shift-Command-V to choose what adjustment I wanna paste on the other clip. But now I can just drag and drop the adjustment I want and leave the ones that I don't want. I might still use that shortcut to copy and paste retiming in some of the video or audio attributes, but for the colors, this is gonna be it. This is gonna be the method I'm gonna use from now on. And that's it, guys. If you got any value from this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more tips and tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.